reluctantly, because they were kind of at their apex and they were fucking huge. And they gave him 6 months off, and then they got back together again.
Is that when he started Angels and Airwaves? Or
could have been. Yeah, right. He wanted to make something a little bit darker. And
how much? It, you can go darker.
Boxcar Racer, isn't that what it's called?
Oh,
he had that one as well.
Right, yeah, you could be right. Yeah, you're right.
But yeah, off he went. And
garbage.
Fucking garbage, lad.
Garbage.
Yeah. Went off, made this shit. Eventually got back together again. I think they released another album. It was fucking scuttered. Didn't do well. Nobody liked it. And then he fucked off. And they brought in Matt Skiba from Alkaline Trio, who got a big enough band.
You like them?
I like Alkaline Trio. You do. They have some good stuff. And,
garbage.
they're more on their
early stuff. Is, I mean, we can say we should do a podcast on their early stuff.
The early stuff
we did it with Coldplay there.
Yeah, they'd be a little bit on the more serious side of kind of scuttery American punk. They have more of a weird indie influence than a straight up punky kind of thing. But they're also another three piece. But Matt Skiba jumped in, and apparently, I would be brutally honest with you, I'm not listening to it. Right?
Did you hear it was good?
I heard it's. I don't know. I think the album they put out with him sold almost as much as Enemy of the State. Like, it was huge.
Yeah.
And it was very well received. But I couldn't tell you. And I'll never be able to tell you because I'm never going to listen to it. It's just never, ever going to happen.
The last I heard from Blink-182 is they're doing a tour with Lil Wayne.
Yeah, when Lil Wayne...
We just talked about.
He just walked off.
I heard that as well.
Yeah, now,
The reason... I don't know whether... I know... When someone said to me they're doing a tour together, I was like, those fans don't particularly match up. And someone sent me the video, the promo video, which was them playing a song with Lil Wayne.
Yeah.
That's not the whole tour, surely.
I think so. No, they have their own sets.
But so the promo video was the two of them doing a song together.
Yeah, it's a crossover in the middle, I think. Yeah, I've seen footage of it. And it's
he like can't, that lad can't, not Lil Wayne. He was the singer of Blink-182, lad. Can't sing anymore.
Mark Hoppus.
To save his life, he cannot.
He never could.
No, but he especially can't.
No, to be honest with you, neither of them really could. I think that was part of the appeal. They just sound like a lot of 13-year-olds with guitars.
But
that
this is the most...
It's mad.
Boris Johnson, Trump idea. You know, this is the year we're living in.
What
we're
do
living
the kids like?
We're now living in Idiocracy, the movie. The movie. 100% now. It's actually... Prophecy.
Enzymes on the fucking corn. Like,
it's just absolute prophecy now. I watched the promo video with Lil Wayne and Blink-182, and I would suggest people watch it if they want to just see what happens.
I watched the video of Lil Wayne saying he was dropping off the tour because the crowds weren't big enough. There was thousands of people there. But he's like, you know, I'm not used to these type of gigs, you know, with this few people. Fucking thousands of people there. Like, he's used to stadiums.
But he still could do stadiums.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah, but he doesn't want that.
No.
He done, like, 3 or 4 of these gigs, and I think he's dropped
Probably because when he gets to his bits, they're really only going to be there for Blink-182. Rap fans are going to look at that going, I'm not going to fucking go to that gig. Fuck, I'll wait till he's back in his own again.
Yeah.
Terrible idea.
It's a weird fucking idea. It's, like, one of those fucking 90s ideas that people had.
Done now, and it's not translated.
Pitch shifter versus therapy. Fuck, it's just one of these weird crossover things that probably won't fucking work.
Yeah.
But I just have a thing about Blink-182. They're one of those bands of a time in my life that I even back then knew were shit. But I got a taste for shite, like, off them.
I will say one of their songs made me laugh out loud. Really, like, loud, the first time I heard it. And I think it's Miss You. Is that the song?
Could be.
Another one goes, don't waste your time on me, you're already... And I was like, what's this? And he goes, the voice inside my head.
Yeah.
I was like, what's my head?
Yeah.
Stay here. Yeah. Just get fuck off. Yeah. Garbage.
Is that called fucking... I think that's Anthem, I think it's called.
I missed you. Yeah. I laughed heartily.
Every now and again, I will bang... one of those two albums, whether Dude Ranch or Enemy of the State, on my headphones walking down the road, and I find myself knowing the words to every song reluctantly. Like, I wish I didn't know them. I wish I knew something more important. You know what I mean? Like, I wish I knew, like, the years that Eamon De Valera was in control of this country instead of the lyrics.
So we can spit on them even harder.
Whatever. Something important, you know? Something important. But I can't help it. Anyway, what's your last one?
This is a new song. This was chart-topping. Could be still top of some charts. Old Town Road by Lil Nas. No relation, I don't think, to Nas. I could be wrong. Don't think so.
Lil Nas X. Which
Lil
one did Nas you pick? Did you pick the Billy Ray or the original?
The Billy Ray one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Which I think is longer than the original one.
By a couple of seconds.
Is it? The original one's 1 minute and 36 seconds
long. This is 2 minutes and 10, I think.
And half of the song is that intro.
Yeah. Nice little intro.
It's fucking painful. I love it.
This is such a stupid song.
It's fucking shy and I love it.
It's so stupid. Do you ever catch yourself singing it?
Yeah, all the time.
Yeah, I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. Yeah. I'm gonna pause. Right.
Yeah. It's impossible. It's impossible not to like.
It's really so stupid. Yeah. Here's first of all, when I first heard it, because I have to DJ chart music, so I have to keep up to date with the absolute scutter that the youth was saying they're listening to anyway.
The youth.
And I started reading up a little bit more about this when I saw Pitchfork doing loads of articles about it. So he entered this song into the country charts because he's a country rapper. It's a hybrid of country and rap, which is a terrible idea.
It's been tried before.
Yeah.
It has been tried before. It's actually, apparently it's a genre.
Do I feel that Nelly did something like that?
Probably. We even Country Grammar, didn't he?
Oh, that's actually where I'm getting it mixed up now.
But no, there has been attempts at doing it. There have been like black cowboy rappers before doing kind of hip hop combo stuff with slow guitars and stuff. It's one of those genres that has started and failed probably 100 times.
Yeah.
This is the one.
The intro has, believe it or not, whether you know the song or not, go check it out. This song has a Nine Inch Nails sample in it. A good chunk of a Nine Inch Nails instrumental from the Ghosts sessions, the album Ghosts 5 or something. I can't remember. It's the Nine Inch Nails album. I was kind of disappointed because it's soundtracky stuff. It's great. It's funny to listen to. You're never going to go back to that.
No.
Ever.
No.
With the bangers that Reznor has. Yeah. Am I right? He's got a Nine Inch Nails sample on it.
That's fucking mad.
It's crazy. That's the number one song for forever. He's probably minted.
Oh yeah,
just based on this because it sold so many.
Yeah,
I've
seen the tweet by him a couple of weeks ago where the label were pushing him to release more music. He's like,
I don't have it. I'm not good.
But he has a new one out apparently as of the last 2 days ago or something.
It's not bad. It's all right. Panini.
It's all right.
You know what? That EP that this is on got shredded by the critics. Everyone going, it's absolute garbage. So I went, I have to listen to this. Yeah, it's going to be terrible. Listen, I was like, it's really not that bad. It's terrible, but it's not.
Yeah,
it's terrible. So anyway. He released it and it went into the country, I won't say country Billboard because I'm not really clued in on what way America ranks its music.
Yeah.
But it got kicked out. It got literally delisted and kicked out of the charts because they said it wasn't country enough.
Yeah. So,
which is the fucking...
Off he went.
It's a risky fucking move saying, oh, you're a rapper? No, you can't. So, like, it's off he went.
Comes back.
Who do I get? Billy Ray Cyrus. Yeah. To lay down some bars. Yeah. Billy Ray's rapping on this, man. Thought, what the fuck is happening to the world right now? We just went from Blink-182 doing it.
Yeah. Billy Ray Cyrus rapping. Yeah.
I swear to God. I think I died. I think I died. And I'm just, my dreams have just actually started to go. Because look at all the things that are happening right now, what we're talking about.
Yeah.
Anyway, he gets him back in. And they have to put it in the charts.
Of course they do.
They have to put it in the country charts. Now, I love the fact that there is possibly hundreds of thousands of people, deep-seated, scummy racists, that this is in their craw.
Yeah.
This is hooked into their throat. And every time they wake up in the morning, here's the new number one song on the country charts. I got them horses in the back. Do you know what?
It's so shit.
And I love that. It's the number one on their lovely little country.
It's so big that fucking Rambo's using it.
Rambo used a really dark version of it. I have that. Then, when you think it can get no better. When you think that that's it, he's going to fade off. It was that time he stuck it to the fucking Cowboys. He comes in and goes, hey, guess what? I'm gay.
I'm pride.
Yeah. I'm gay.
Yeah.
Just when they couldn't.
It's about to die. Have this.
They're already dead now.
Exactly.
They're already dead.
Have this. And then he goes on Twitter and he starts fucking tweeting at Kim Kardashian about some photo he took. Did you see this?
No.
So he starts tweeting at Kim Kardashian. He's like fucking full of like dot, dot, dot at Kim Kardashian. He's like, hey, Kimmy, will you post up that picture you took of me and Kanye the other day? And she posts up and it's just this picture of Kanye West kind of sitting in this golf buggy, like not even knowing what's going on with this fucking black cowboy standing beside him, like thumbs up. And fucking, like, it was obviously taken before Kanye knew who the fuck he was, that he had a big song.
Yeah.
And Kanye's just looking away, like, what is this
lunatic?
What is this cunt?
Because Lil Nas wears full on jackets with the things, tassels hanging down. Bang. Absolute. He's game ball in on this.
Yeah. 100% balls deep in this.
This is his music.
Yeah.
He's not going to drop this.
He's a drover. Like, he's fucking ranchero. He's fucking having it, like. Yeah. And he's going to ride this into the fucking sunset.
When he came out, right. Now, I'm not obviously trying to take some sort of, like, what's the word? Extra. I mean, that shit's going to be fucking really hard for him to be a black gay man in America anyway.
And throw cowboy in.
Yeah. But I'm not trying to take some sort of solace in this but I really do love that it annoyed some people who I don't like. A section of society that I really don't like. Yeah. I just had this image of a guy out fly fishing and someone going, that Lil Nas song's number one again. Yeah, I'm just, you know, making peace with it. You know that he's gay as well, and you just see Chet walking into the river. That's it. He's done.
I just can't.
He's walking into the river. What are you doing?
I just can't.
I'm out.
Yeah, I'm out. Oh, fuck. All right.
Listen, you've got one left.
I've got one left, right, and I'm just going to bang through it, and it's Hate Breed. Right, it's Hate Breed. I know. Yeah. Again, I can't help it.
I can see where the controversy comes from. You mentioned Hate Breed to a lot of people, like, oh,
they're fucking terrible, right? They're terrible. However, they have one album. Actually, that's a lie. They have two albums that are fucking spectacular. Spectacular. And both of these albums, I think there's kind of three phases in Hatebreed's life. You've got the original kind of hardcore Victory Records era, and they're doing an EP called Under the Knife that was okay, and then an album called Satisfaction is the Death of Desire, and it's fucking super, right?
That's a great album title as well.
Satisfaction.
I don't mind that. I listened to it a few times, and
fucking, for that style of music, it's fucking whopper. It works, right? Then they went off and they became this kind of shitty American metalcore band.
Them and Chimera and all those bands. Yeah,
they put this album out called Perseverance, which I don't rate. I don't think it's
that's
very
a huge one.
It's huge. I don't think it's
you spit
good.
In my eye. Wipe the spit.
It's that Triple X song. Wipe the spit from my face.
Wipe the tears from my. What are you crying for in the song?
Will Vin Diesel's fucking snowboarding down the mountain. You know, it's fucking bullshit. It doesn't do much for me at all.
Yeah.
The album they put out after that is called The Rise of Brutality, and I think it's fucking perfect. Perfect. It's whatever they done, it fired on all cylinders. And they had the song I picked off that album, the song that's called Doomsayer, and it's one of my top metal songs of all time. The riff in it is outrageous, and it makes you want to dropkick your mat down the stairs. Like, if you found yourself in the right position and that song came on your headphones or was loud enough,
she's going down.
Someone's going down. Yeah, granny's getting suplexed off the roof. Fucking whatever. You're hitting a baby. It doesn't matter. Something fucking mad is happening when you fucking hear that song. It's so fucking hefty and, like, alive. It's fucking insane. The album is fucking incredible. I spent a fortune on it on vinyl a while ago trying to find it, because it's from that, like, poxy fucking time where records weren't really that big.
They just stopped making them. It was pointless.
Like 2003 or something like that. It was just before records
2007 there was a big drop off.
But that fucking album is fucking. They brought one out called Supremacy that's fucking terrible. Then a covers album where he stopped roaring and shouting and started singing.
Jamie Jesta, is that the singer?
Yeah.
Sound as fucking by all accounts. Lovely fella.
He's missing a thumb.
Is he?
Yeah, his thumb is missing. You ever see photos of him? He hides a thumb in behind his hands.
Oh, right.
Yeah, weird little fucking thing.
Don't take a photo of my thumb.
There's also a Hate Breed cover band called Hate Beak. Which has a parrot singer. Yeah, no messing. And they're called Hate Beak, and it's literally a parrot just squawking while a lot of people play Hate Breed songs. There's one called Hate Bread, which is like a concept album where they change all the lyrics about like sourdough and batch. I'm not messing. Because they're fucking, they're cartoony as fuck, you know. I've seen them a couple of times live. The first gig they ever done in Ireland was in Whelan's, and it was quite possibly the loudest, heaviest gig I'd ever seen. It was around the time of that Rise of Brutality. If you like heavy music, forget about the garbage, me head fucking shit that surrounds Hatebreed.
There is so much bro dude.
It's absolute.
Bro, like, dude.
Pantera 2, basically.
Yeah.
All it is. Like, forget about that. Listen to Rise of Brutality. It's fucking epic. It's a killer album. I think we're going to leave it at that for this week, because we're going to have to go on overtime again. But they were our controversial lights. I'm fucking, I've got hiccups now. I'm drinking beer.
Slag us over these, will you?
Please
slag us.
Come back. Get us.
Get us over this. It is your mission. Fucking, come on, do it. Do it.
Just do it.
Just do it.
Leave her now. Just fucking do it. Yeah, hit us up. give us a hard time. Tell us what your controversial likes are.